Welcome to the students of class 7. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter from your history lessons. And just open your book in your page number 16. And the name of the chapter is The New Kings and Kingdoms. So in this chapter we will learn that how the in medieval period some different kings and emerged and they spread their kingdoms and what are the political rivalry and the economic and social features of those kingdoms. Previously in class 6 we have learned how Gupta Empire established in the subcontinent, but after the decline of Gupta Empire the many new dynasties emerged in the 18th century. After the decline of Gupta dynasty, lot of small dynasties emerged, small kingdoms emerged in Indian subcontinent, such as Chola, Gujjar Pratihara, Pala, Rashtrakuta and others also like Parmar, Chandels, those parts also. Now look at the map. A map is also present in your book. So compare these two maps. I have drawn the similar type of map here. It is not identical, but it is helpful to understand all these dynasties and their places where they ruled. First, look at this. I am starting from the South India. That is the farthest south. It is the Pandyas. The Pandyas, Pandya rulers ruled in the farthest southern region of India. And today's those Rameshwar, Kannakumari, the those regions. Next one, Cheras. Cheras ruled in the area, in the state today known as Kerala. So, on that region, that time, Cheras ruled. So, the area of Cheras is as these areas. Now, Cholas. What is the area of Cholas? The Cholas ruled up to this vast territory. And they also, after sometimes they also increase their power and they spread their empire towards the north and eastern India. Next one, Rashtrakuta. In the southern India, today's Maharashtra, some part of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh also consist in the Indian area. So this area, I mark it. Lines so this area is the place of Rashtrakuta dynasty. So this is the area of Rashtrakutas. Next, the Gujjara Pratihara. Gujjara Pratihara is the most powerful dynasty that is spread their empire in the western India, northwestern India, and also in today's Rajasthan in Rajputana region. And also, and beside them, the Chahamanas. Chahamanas also established their kingdom in the area. So, the Gujjara Pratihas, so their area is almost this. This is a huge area. You can easily understood. I mark with some dots. So, this is the area controlled by the Gujjara Pratihas. Now, the Palas, yes, the Palas spread their dynasties over this region. This is the area of Palas. It is also today's Bihar, West Bengal, and most of the part of today's Bangladesh. And some part of Odisha is included in the Pala dynasty. You mark them in horizontal lines. This is the area of Palas. And there's the other dynasties also, like Ganga dynasty in Odisha. Okay. And also Chandels in central India and Tomara Chand in northern India and Chandels in central India. So these are some dynasties, they spread their kingdom and after the decline of Gupta Empire. So in this way, different dynasties spread their dominion over different parts of Indian subcontinent. Now, in the next subunit, we'll see how these dynasties, they established their dominion over this particular region and how did they gain acceptance from the society. In the next subunit, the emergence of new dynasties. How new dynasties emerged at the time and they took over their power, those and the Samantas in the okay. So first, Dantidurga was a Samanta under the Chalukya rulers. Chalukya rulers ruled in the mid southern region, though today's some part of Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka and Maharashtra. So those region was ruled by Chalukyas. But Rashtrakuta, the founder of Rashtrakuta dynasty, Dantidurga was a first was a Mahasamanta. Then he was gained his power and wealth, and one day he overthrew his Chalukya overlord and also organized a ritual called Hiranyagarbha, means golden womb ritual. Why this ritual organized? Because you have seen in previous classes, in previous class 6, that how Ashwamedha or Rajaswa, Vajapaya, this kind of yajnas performed to gain acceptance. The Samantas gain acceptance, the Rajas gain acceptance and they become empire. So in the same way, he also gained acceptance from the society and he invited all the Brahmanas and the rest of the Samantas and so his supremacy and become the and established a new dynasty, that is Rashtrakuta dynasty. And though Dantidurga was not from the Kshatriya background, he was from other backgrounds, lower backgrounds, but he emerged himself and his dynasty as a Kshatriya clan, so by the Hiranyagarbha ritual. So in this way, Dantidurga established established his Rashtrakuta dynasty in the western, in the southwestern part of India, that is in today's Maharashtra, some part of Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh. So now, in the similar way, some other people like Gujjara Pratihara Harichandra and Kadamba Maurya Sharmana, they are Brahmins, but they gave up their traditional occupation like the teaching and the work of priest, and they took to arms and become and established their own dynasties. And Gujjara Pratihara Harichandra established his own dynasty in Rajasthan, it is Gujjara Pratihara dynasty, and Kadamba Maurya Sarvana established his own kingdom at Karnataka, it is Kadamba dynasty, and the name of the dynasty is Kadamba dynasty. So in this way we have seen that how some local rulers, some Samantas become powerful and they took some titles like Mahamandaleshwara, Mahasamanta, then they overthrow their kings and their other dynasties and took over their rulers' empire and established their own dynasty and own kingdom. Dynasty means a clan, a family, and kingdom means you know. So in this way, the new dynasties emerged in the 8th century. All this happened from 8th to between 12th century AD. Next, we'll discuss about another powerful kingdom, that is Chola kingdom. How Chola is established in the southern part of India, we'll discuss in the next class. Hope you have understood this chapter. So, see you in the next class and thank you for watching.